In the output section, you find the control room of your venue. From this control room, you set up the microphones in the room. This is an essential step, and every sound engineer will confirm how important the microphones are. We have already picked very good microphone locations for you. These are the locations we have recorded the thousands of impulse responses from. Some rather obvious observations. The closer you move your main microphone to the stage, the closer your instrument will sound. The further you move away from your instrument or section, the more narrow your impression of the stereo width will become. Whenever you reposition an instrument, give MIR PRO a little time to load the corresponding data, indicated by the wheel in the upper left corner. If you decide to move a microphone from its original position, the resulting sound will be extrapolated from the existing data, which can lead to exciting effects. Some of them are also described in the tutorial sections of the MIR PRO manual. Back to the output section, our control room, to pick your main microphone. Your selection here also defines your output format, from stereo to 7.1. And of course this setting has to match the settings in your host sequencer to take effect. And if you like, you can add a secondary microphone for an even more spacious impression. Remember that this microphone does not contain any direct signal from the stage. It's actually a room microphone. And just to have said it, runtime delays are automatically taken care of, just like the stereo panorama that changes depending on the distance from the recording microphone and many other little details. So this is not a static recording situation. Feel free to adapt the settings and explore the possibilities. Different microphone setups will sound differently, and if you like, you can even design a microphone tree yourself. Use our presets as starting points and change the parameters for each microphone separately. The output matrix lets you assign up to 8 virtual microphone capsules to any number of physical outputs. You can define the global dry volume handling, and even change the reverberation time of the whole venue. This way you will keep the characteristics of the room sound, but the impression of the size will change. Take advantage of the global dry-wet offset slider to check if the overall amount of reverberation fits the music you're working on. You can also listen to the dry and wet signal in solo. And there is also a room equalizer to fine-tune your MIR PRO venue sound. Finally, we have also captured the room tone of each venue. If you are using MIR PRO in Vienna Ensemble Pro, you need to add a dedicated MIR PRO room tone channel to activate this feature. When using MIR PRO as a plugin, the RT button will activate the room tone right away. Then you can adjust the amount of room tone or ambient noise with the volume slider in the MIR PRO plugin interface or directly in the output section. Last but not least, there's an additional plugin available, Miracle, an algorithmic reverb plugin designed to sweeten your mix and give it that expensive touch. Use Miracle on the sum of your MIR PRO mix, and you'll hear that it creates that soaring sound you're after. Miracle is also available as a separate plugin in your sequencer now, so you can apply it to the sum of your MIR PRO mix just as well. We wish you a lot of joy exploring the magic of Vienna MIR PRO.